Yeah, well, working with David Thorn is a very exciting experience. Painful and certainly offbeat at times, but nonetheless very, very exciting.
Today's top story. A dedicated theater director from the Bronx may just get his big break after a solid 10 years of struggling.
That's right, Gene. Known as theater champion throughout the streets of New York, David Thorn, an off-off-Broadway director from the Bronx, has possibly just got his big break into real directing.
Exactly 1 year ago, David Thorn published his autobiography entitled Thorns and Roses about his life as an actor-slash-director in the city, growing up with his family, and founding his company, the David Thorn Theater Company, when he was only, get this, Kelly, 22.
And recently, it was picked up by Academy Award-nominated screenwriter from the Amish family drama, No More Tears, Bruce Bishop, who adapted the screenplay, and it has been greenlit by producers Dick Foster's and Larry Cummings of Foster's Cumming Productions.
Dick Foster's and Larry Cumming have insisted on making the film stroll down a rather different path. Apparently, they're making it extremely raw and guerrilla style with a low budget, yeah, and really making it feel like it's his own life. Let's say Apocalypse Now meets The Goodbye Girl.
Well, I don't know about that, Gene, but the film is using a lot of unknown actors, with the exception of international action movie star Chuck Nolan. According to Chuck Nolan's agent, he is looking forward to be playing a film that is very low budget, and he is ready to tackle something that is very low key, very challenging, and very deep.
Is in production as we speak.
Whoa, in a couple of days, the coma take me away, but the press let the story leak.
You know, teaching is definitely what I do best.
Okay, so I'm gonna introduce a new game. I don't know if you guys have heard of this game. It's zip zap bop, and then he can do it back to you, and he can do it to you, and then you can do it to him, and then you can do it to me. Okay, zap. What did I just say?
Me?
Stop dropping the coins. Or I'll drop you on your head.
There are times, you know, when I wake up in the morning more often than not and just say to myself, you know, God, what's the point in living? You know, what's the point of life? You know, why go about doing the same old shit every day and just put myself out of my pathetic misery? I'm kind of done with this.
Butcher the words of Shakespeare. Butcher the words of Shakespeare. Get out of here. Get out of here. Okay, so what'd you do today?
I came to the acting class.
And shut up! See, that's what's gonna happen. Can you give me the ball, please? That's how it's gonna go down, guys.
Writing. Well, I mean, I've been writing since I was a kid. I can just sit down and write at this point, and it's just a nice thing to do for me. My father, now he was a circus clown. He was actually really into that, kind of to a creepy point even. Talking real into that. He had an incredibly giant heart and beautiful soul, but Rufus! What are you doing? What did I tell you about singing? Yeah, thank you. I don't sublet this place so you can just sit around and sing all day. Yeah. Do something with your life, Jesus Christ. Yes, my father. On the outside, the guy appears to be somewhat of a raging alcoholic. You know, around my neighborhood, what would happen more often than not is he'd come home, drown his sorrows in Guinness, and then run around playing Ding Dong Ditch or asking for free Walmart coupons. I mean, Jesus, it was all in good fun, but of course the authorities get called, they come. You know, they tell us to go along our merrily ways, but he was real into that shit, man.
Who's Chuck Nolan, baby? Who's Chuck Nolan? Chuck Nolan!
So,
this house here is I really wanted it to represent human development. You know, you have the physical, the health, the mental development, which is of course very important, and you know, artistic development. For example, now this I had custom made for myself here. It's based on these Indian murals that are actually miniatures, okay? And these Indian artists are just, they're fantastic, and the detail that they get into these paintings are amazing. You know, it's mind blowing, and you know, of course I need something bigger for myself, so. Started living in New York, you know, the only way I could make ends meet was to be a male prostitute. But, you know, the things an actor has to do to earn some cash, right? One night, I have this client of mine, this foxy fox named Paula, and you know, she just happened to be the casting director for the new sitcom Moon Donkey, about an astronaut donkey, and she asked me, after I, you know, finished pleasuring her, of course, she asked me what I really want to do with my life. So immediately I told her, you know, I want to be an actor. And that one client was to change my life forever. And she pays well. So she ended up giving me the second lead in the sitcom, first lead being the donkey, of course. But I got to play Rory Shakes, who's like this, you know, this beefy model who falls in love with the donkey after she returns to planet Earth. But our relationship starts stirring up all kinds of trouble in the local town. So it was funny stuff. But, you know, the show, it started causing a lot of controversy, you know, with the environment and the economy. But I did a lot of research for the part. I went to some ranches, and I really just, I wanted to see donkeys, you know, doing stuff, like, you know, like eating, taking shits, you know, just really immersed myself in the role. I watched Space Camp a lot.
Yeah, I have some leftovers, so after yoga today, you can totally come over and we can have a goat-tooth party. Yeah, just don't forget your mat today at yoga practice, because that was annoying last time.
I have to go.
Hello, Chanolin. How are you doing today? Welcome to the dinner. How are you doing? You good?
Yeah.
I love you. I love you and every single thing you've ever done. Even the crappy ones, at least 5 times, I really have. Okay, so just give this to me. Okay, stop. We need to talk, because it's not every day I get to meet. Please. It's not every day you get to meet Chuck Nolan, so I just was wondering, what is High Voltage 2 coming out? Really? You don't know? You're in it. Oh, you're the star. You see that painting right over there? I could totally do that. I have a really interest in art, and I think I could be big. Yeah, but anywho, I have a niece, and she loves you just as much as I do, and I was wondering if you could just give her an autograph. It's okay.
No autographs.
Sweet, I'm having a goat cheese party later if you want to come. I'll send you an email. Okay.
She was pretty hot for an assistant house manager. You cheated me at $30,000. You cheated me at $30,000. You call yourself actors, huh? You wanna fucking dedicate yourself to the theater, the arts, the craft, all you fucking motherfuckers, you fucking jumbo fucks! Oh, goddammit! Oh,
You all look at me. Don't keep your eyes fucking closed, but you all look at me. Look at me, because I'm the fucking director. I'm directing this movie. And if you got, oh, I swear to God, God, so help me, God, have mercy on all your fucking souls. This movie is gonna turn into shit. Now, excuse me, I'll be back in my own personal trailer to recap my entire life. Knock on my door when you guys broke the fuck up, you fucking pansies.
David,
what the fuck do you want?
Sorry,
Mr. Duncan,
just go to the bathroom.
Yeah, go, you fucking tampon. Ooh, look at me, I'm Mickey, you're Brittany. What?
We're sorry about that. They aren't used to these theater exercises.
Yeah. Yeah.
Especially
that's
Shaka. You know, once you become as big as star as Shaka is, I have a moment to tell you.
Like, tell me what?
I'm sorry. We need to talk to you about your trailer.
Well, what about it?
Well, this is an independent film. Our budget's only $50,000. I mean, with the credit
crisis,
budget, bathing supplies, we just don't have the money. We discussed this with you beforehand, David. There's no money in our budget to get you a personal trainer.
I don't see the problem. What's the problem? I don't get it.
Since this one time, I had a big pimple on my buttocks.
Maybe get your number, call you sometime.
You want my telephone number?
Yeah. Come on. Keep that shit.
That's a really, really long number.
It's Russian, in Russian.
Oh, that's why I can't read so much.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, to put it plainly, we only have enough money for the must-have items of the list.
Excuse me for being bluntly, but what could be more important than my own personal trailer, you tell me?
Well, bluntly, transportation, purpose, sex, costume, props, beverages.
Okay, enough. So let me get it straight. Correct me if I'm wrong here, Larry. I can get my own personal trailer because minor things like permits and props?
Yeah, exactly. That's it. You're on the right track, David.
How about you just stick a burning fork in my eye? Right?
Yes. I beg your pardon?
How about you just chuck me into a pool of acid, huh? See if I can swim. Watch me sizzle. Go ahead.
We're just having a little conversation. If you just go right back, continue what you were doing, it's brilliant.
I'm totally on.
You know, I'm just gonna go back to work on my actors, get them revved up for the first day of filming, and then we'll get the ball rolling. I swear to God, huh? You scumbags. Hey, sorry about getting money problems. What can you do?
Well, where do we begin?
It's been some journey these past few years.
Let's just start where you first met.
Oh, jeez Louise, here we go.
He hates this story. Anyway, it was a few years ago, 2004, I was 30, and Larry was a few years younger than I was.
Yes, I was 21.
Anyway, he was working at this local stocking shop. Now, I heard about him, of course, because he was Employee of the Month 3 months in a row.
Oh, big whoop.
Oh, come on now, it's an accomplishment.
You know, the story of words matter.
Anyway. Now, I would drive down to his stocking shop, which was in Venice, not exactly local, was it?
No, it wasn't.
So, I would leave my studio in Studio City, drive 45 minutes to an hour to his Stop and Shop in Venice, buy a half pound of bologna and some raspberry swirl ice cream.
It was ridiculous. I don't know why in the world they would do it. And this would be every other day, mind you. I mean, I believe there's a Stop and Shop 2 blocks from where you were.
But it was filthy.
So was I.
Yeah.
Well, we started Foster's Coming Productions back freshly last year, 2007, and it's been quite an adventure. Dick here has just sort of shown me the ropes inside and outside of the bedroom.
Yes, I mean, we have suffered terribly trying to be taken seriously. I mean, it's a wonder we're still here to actually tell you the story today, though. I can't believe it myself.
Okay, continue. Come on in. Let's go. Time is my here.
Okay.
chicks out of here.
Okay, I'll
start shooting in 2 days. I need the chicks.
No problem. I will take the chicks. I will take the chicks.
Get the dead cockroach out of there. Jesus Christ. Get the cockroach?
Yes. No problem.
No. What are you going to eat it?
Jesus Christ.
Oh, what is that? Get that. Come on, let's go.
Necessarily enjoy being personal assistant, but you know, it seems like the only thing I can do right now. I come from big family of personal assistants. My parents was personal assistant. My uncle was personal assistant. My aunt was personal assistant. You know, there is great Russian expression about getting big break. It goes something like this. Хорошо, спасибо, что такое, как дал ягба, папа что-то. And this means there is no formula for success except the unconditional acceptance. And the punishment of getting fingers cut off if need be.
Hey, Zoe. What's up? You caught him doing what?
That's you, my friend. So, the American accent, Dan. I need the accent to be down pat. Because I don't know, I know you studied at some kind of playhouse, but I don't know how you did it back there. I don't know if you worked on any dialects, but it's, if it is an American film.
It's not a big deal if your boyfriend wants to pee on you. Me and Brad do it all the time. I mean, just have to make sure he drinks a lot of water first. So it's not like yellow, because that's not good.
When I you came in here telling me that you can do an American accent, and I've yet to see it, my friend. So I need that accent down pat, because if I don't have that down, then it defeats the whole purpose of it being an American film. I can't have a Colombian agent when I'm supposed to be an American agent. It's my life, my story, my film. Got it? Yeah. So do you understand? I love the scruff, my friend. I love the scruff. I love the outfit. I love the outfit, but I just need the accent down. Okay? If I don't have the accent down, I'll fire you. Okay? I'll fire you. Like that. I don't know what your status is as an immigrant in this country, but I'll fire you.
Oh, where did it sting you? No, honey, I think that's like herpes.
I don't give a fuck, okay? I'm crazy. I'm okay. All right, my friend. Oh, shit. I gotta go get the elevator, so all right, my friend, I'll talk to you soon, okay?
Hold
on,
okay,
please.
Zoe, that's
enough
of the
pinky
talk, right?
Yeah,
I'm not
too much on
you,
also, I think.
Oh, you
didn't
have to hang up on account
of me. Oh, it's okay. It was kind of a private conversation anyway,
so. I see.
What was it about? What was the conversation about?
I told you it was private.
Cool. Friend of yours, though?
Yeah.
Awesome. So, you have fun today?
Yeah.
Hey, you definitely got a little spunk there, Brittney. Definitely do. You know, it's really refreshing. You know, how you carry yourself, your appearance, your confidence, you know. So, I mean, I definitely think you could work wonders with the character of Vicky. You know, she was an important person in my life, and I'm glad I chose you for the part, huh? Never know, 10, 15 years from now, that potential talent you have now could progress into a promising young actress like Meryl Streep or a future crackhead like my sister. You know, it's all up to you. Right? It's all about the path you take, you know, the choices you make. You know, the world is your crap gig, as they say, right? So what are you going to do tonight? Any plans?
I'm probably just go home, sit on my fat ass, eat like 3 bags of chips, watch the OC.
God, that sounds depressing. Well, if you get lonely, which you most likely will, you could always slug yourself out of my apartment and sit on your fat ass there. What do you say? All right, I'll see you tomorrow. I'll see. Remember, we're doing the stripper scene and your powerful scene. Fucking idiot. A wise philosopher once said that love without return is like a question without an answer. My ex-wife, she wasn't exactly what you call handsome or attractive in the traditional sense. She was, she was cute. Well, her teeth were a little fucked up, but for the most part, she had a great personality. It's a spectacular moment when you marry someone. And even worse, when they leave you for two overweight women and a transvestite dwarf. But that's her path in life. So, rest. Stupid busted bitch.
cheated me. Cheated me. Out of $30,000. You cheated me out of $30,000. Try not to say the same line over and over again different ways, because it doesn't really produce a positive result. You want to have all spontaneity. You follow me?
Yeah. Listen.
Yeah.
I'm thinking maybe from like now on, mm-hmm. you could call me by my character's name, and just really help me like jump into the role.
You want me to call you by my name as a character?
No, my character's name.
So I call you David. Let's try it. Hi, David.
I'm Chuck.
Hi, David.
Chuck Nolan.
I know you're Chuck Nolan. All right. Okay. Hey.
Okay.
All right. Bye.
You cheated me out of $30,000?
I don't know what's going on.
You cheated me out of $30,000?
I think you're misled.
I think you're misled. Okay, where's
okay.
my money?
Hey, stop. Okay. David,
just so you know, everybody, we're all calling Chuck David now to help with this character.
Now, you said cheating.
Listen, pal. You might as well. Because I'm getting that other $30,000.
You want me to say that?
Yeah. Okay, good. Now, Chima, I want you to get up and fight Chuck.
Come on, Spawn. I really don't think you should do this.
What are you afraid to fight him, Chima?
No, it's a chicken.
You think you can take me?
Oh,
shit. Are you pretty boy?
We need to stick to the text. Need to stick to the text.
Okay.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I know what you're talking about, but am I gonna do it? I don't know, because I mean, this film, we're trying to, you know.
The improv needs
I mean,
to
stop.
The improv needs to stop now. I don't know who the fuck this guy is. High voltage motherfucker, Jean-Claude Van Damme Jr. He can't improv, okay? He's not Robert De Niro.
Jesus, okay.
He's
okay.
taking.
No, he didn't mean that, David, okay? He didn't mean that. Don't worry about it, okay? I'll call him David now, so don't get that confused.
Okay, David? Okay, David,
I won't get
one.
A popsicle.
Hey, can you get me a popsicle?
You'll get a popsicle.
I like the chocolate ones. So what are you saying about the text?
Okay, yeah.
That's a popsicle. Popsicles are different.
Get the fuck out of here! You motherfucker, if you don't look at me in the eyes.
Hey, okay, now listen to what I'm saying.
You can't whip this! I wrote the fucking thing! I wrote the
shots! Okay, Bishop, you can't just come out of here from LA and start calling the shots, okay? Directing's a lot harder than writing, like, fuck.
Directing? You are gonna talk to me about directing?
Bruce Bishop, everyone! Ooh! Academy Award nominee, no more tears! Ooh!
You!
Thomas! Oh, don't you clap!
I'm not happy with what David's doing with this script. You know, I signed on to adapt his novel because I thought it had true potential. Can I see where the producers are coming from? Kinda, I mean, yeah, it stirs up a lot of excitement in the papers. Lets those New York theater directors run around with a little hope, you know, thinking maybe this could happen to me, but it's just, you know, it's doubtful. It's just really doubtful. But I guess we like to give people hope, don't we? What I'm trying to say is I put a lot of time into writing this script. And it seems like he barely even uses it anymore. And, you know, it's stupid. It's a bad idea. The guy doesn't know what the fuck he's doing. He's really just butchering his own book in a way.
Chima's just busting my nuts about the diaper business because, in fact, I was in the diaper business. Okay, sort of. You know, I mean, you know, I promoted them with my body, you know? I mean, I was freelancing with Paula, so she ended up setting me up with some modeling auditions, and for various products, right? And, okay, one product I was known for back in the mid-90s was Adult Boom Diapers, okay? I mean, that was a big hit in 95, and what they were adult diapers for, like, you know, middle-aged men and women who suffered from irritable bowel syndrome, right? But you could also use them as like a fashion statement, which I think is what most people use them for. You have that motivation, guys? You have that drive for this scene? I really need you guys to listen to each other this time. I really understand one another. You guys have a very beautiful bond. All right.
I need to tell you
How?
Okay, stop. I just want to let you know you got that time, so you step onto the set, you're in a whole other environment, isolated from the outside world. Now tell me, whose cell phone is that? Sorry about that, guys. Just be a minute.
Hey, wow, it's,
David,
hold on, just a minute. Hey, wow, it's, been a long time. I know, how are you? Good, I'm actually, in the middle of a shoot right now, what's up? No, don't be silly, it's perfectly fine, they don't mind. Yeah, fire away, what is it? Right, of course I know, that was a fun night. Yeah. Yeah, man, when I sipped that cranberry vodka out of your belly button, God, I was so wasted. What? What do you mean? Just 1 minute, guys.
Oh, we are safe.
Yes, I understand that, Gail. Jesus Christ. No. No, I'm sorry, but no. This is not my goddamn problem. You definitely told me those condoms would never break. You told me! I trusted you! At least I thought I did. Why'd you have to tell me this right now, huh? Why on God's green earth did you have to tell me this right now? You know I'm in the midst of my big break. I just can't believe you waited this fucking long to tell me. Eight fucking years! You know what? I have work to do, so you call me back when you find out who the real father is. Because that kid ain't mine, sister. Goodbye.
Everything all right?
I gotta go home. I'll be back for the next shoot, okay?
I'm sorry.
What? Listen, asshole. I gotta go home and think something's over, okay? I'm sick. I feel really nauseous and I got a migraine the size of the Grand Canyon. And all I want to do is go home and lie in my bathtub with a glass of Pinot Grigio and some Ritz crackers. Will you let me do that, guys, huh? Will you let me do that just as one night?
No, we could have pulled some strings, but here... You're 4 months behind, David.
What are you blabbing about, Fosters? We can still make that release day, whatever you have to... I like that time.
Yep.
So
it's
what if...
It's August.
So what if it's almost August? We still have over a year for that supposed release date. Jesus.
It's August 2009, not 08, asshole.
Hey, you cool it, Clay Aiken. Or I'll be thrown in prison so goddamn fast that it'll make your cock crooked. Is that what you want, Dick? A crooked cock? Because right. I'm going to give it, all right, give it to you.
Shove my crooked cock, you little
shit. It is not a money-grubbing fuck.
It is not.
You lone shark.
It is not crooked.
Yeah, I'll make it.
I do want to slap you again. Do you want it? Is that what you want, Shorty? I'll do it.
What?
I'll slap your ass.
Okay. What were you about to say? Be professional. Be professional. Jesus Christ. This is America.
We are about to pull the plug on this. We got no money. Your backtracking is your year-long. We have nothing to show.
Hey! Now, who the hell is pouring their heart and soul into this epic masterpiece, huh? Who's taking his own money and putting into this film, huh? Who's taking his money and his own wallet to make this film the best it can be, huh? Me or you guys?
We are, David.
Why are you wearing that to the gym again?
They're comfy and they
move. They're silk. They're comfy.
But they're good for the running. Like they don't chafe. They just
run. You're doing that for that new trainer, aren't you?
Oh, they're other animals. Oh. No.
No, you're wearing your good shoes and your silk pants, and your lucky Batman T-shirt. You're trying to get lucky with a new trainer, aren't you?
It's just a...
No, you are!
Who doesn't want to be Batman? It's why... When I work out,
How you doing, guys?
David.
Hi!
David?
And what?
Are you...
What do you want?
Hello,
guys.
David,
how you doing?
You good?
Okay, no, don't touch my power phone, okay? I beg your pardon? Why would I be drunk? Listen, gentlemen, I decided that I'm gonna skip the shoot today, you know what I mean?
What?
You know what I mean, after that phone call, maybe, I think I'm just gonna skip this entire week, you know what I mean, after that phone call yesterday. Good God, I mean, God only knows, right? I mean, you know, I have a baby now, you know, I just gotta recap my entire life. I have a baby, you know, a little papa. I'm a dad.
I thought I should take some time off, go to the spa, get a tan, maybe go to Vegas and buy some hookers. I don't know. I don't know if I'm gonna have enough time. But here's the thing, fellas. While I'm on my vacation, which I'm sure we all agree I deserve, I thought that maybe you guys could take over for me.
David?
Finish the movie.
You can't. You finish the movie!
No, you. We're paying you to finish the movie.
I'm paying you to pay the movie.
Hi. No, he's back. I understand that. We just want to cut our losses right now. Can we have your approval? No, I understand. No, we aren't. There's no way he's... He's... Right now, he is poking my partner in the nipple.
What?
He is... Yeah.
Don't make that noise.
But that's great.
On this film, I'm gonna be well off for quite some time. After this film, skyrockets!
You know this Jessica Simpson?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, you know this?
Yeah.
She has boyfriend. This is Tony Romero. This is a basketball player. And
right.
He's cheating on her. Yes.
Oh my God.
With this woman, she has no face. She has no face, look.
No, she has a face. They blocked it out.
Oh, you know this Jessica Simpson?
Uh-huh.
She's an American pop singer, mm-hmm. huh?
Yeah.
I like this.
Yeah.
I like this.
Yeah. You're really weird.
Yes.
Hi, Anna. Hello. You dirty mutt. Hey, how you doing?
I'm fine.
What do you got there, man?
Just looking at a picture of my boy, please. Just a picture of my boys. Please.
Whoa! Please. Those are some beautiful kids you got there. What are they, what are they, Korean?
Zimbabwean.
Oh, the Sunshine State, wow.
You know I died once?
No shit.
Thank you very much.
Appreciate it. Okay, everyone, gather around, please.
Guys,
gather around! Shut up, David! You're a drunken prick!
Hey, Dick, is this gonna take that long? Because I got a massage in like an hour.
Anyway! As I was
saying. So was that a no, or...?
David, you have a penis on your forehead.
Hey, yeah, you like that, Lair, huh? You...
I really don't like it.
So, I'm very sorry, I've just gotten off the phone with the board of directors. And we've decided to pull the plug on Thorn and Roses. So.
What?!
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus Christ! Oh yeah? You think this is gonna ruin me, huh? Is that what you two ass donkeys think? Huh?
David, this has been one catastrophe after another. Bruce Bishop wants his name off of the film.
What?
We've lost so much money, our house is going into foreclosure.
Uh-huh.
Now, I understand that you're new to this business and we have tried to help you out. We've given you an extra week, but you blew it!
I blew it.
You came in here drunk, you little shit! You smell of gin and piss!
Oh, yeah.
And now, you get a phone call and you're telling us that you've become too famous and gotten a whore pregnant and now you're leaving the production. Let me tell you something, you little fuck. You do not belong in this industry. You work years to get into this industry and then decades scratching and clawing to try and stay in this fucking industry. You do not belong here, little man. Now, I know you've directed your little off-and-on-again shows in the city, and that's wonderful! We appreciate that. We have tried to adapt to your structure, but we can't, and I think this decision is best for all of us.
Yeah. Anything you have to say, Larry?
We pretty much knew this was going to happen.
Right from the read-through.
Yeah.
Whoa, that was uncalled for.
Were you at the read-through? Do you remember it?
Yes!
Listen. This film may never get made. Maybe it will, but probably no. But you wrote a good book. You should be proud of that, alright? Good book. But... Maybe go back to theater?
Yeah.
No more film.
You go
Don't,
back to theater.
No.
We
shut up. Shut up. Both of you, just shut up. Go back to theater. Finish that. Because you suck here, alright? Anyway. Well, do you have anything else you'd like to say? Anything, just one last thing, we'll get it out of the way.
The Playwright Theater Company in the Bronx. I'm making $3.50, so this is good for me.
Wow.
Big money. Huh. And I'm using the Windex and I'm cleaning. And David is a director in this company.
Artistic director. Right?
Yes, artistic director. So we are like two peas in the pod.
Rumors have been speculating that your relationship with David is not just work-oriented. There's a little more to it. Like a possible romance, maybe?
This is very embarrassing for me because, you know, they are saying in Hollywood not to talk about the relationship and not to talk about, you know, the sexual relationship. But this is true. And David, Thorn, and me, we got married.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I guess.
I finally raised the Lord, the artistic director, for the Playwrights Theater of the Bronx. I mean, I'm like walking on air right now, you know. It's been unbelievable, you know.
You know, we got t-shirts, so you know it's official. And we got David Thorn Theater Company on the front. Nice stuff. And on the back, sneaky, what's on the back? We got a 2010 season. Yes, 2010 season. You know, we got a lot of good stuff. We got about 8 shows lined up. We got a Butch Cassidy and the Sundance radio play. We got a Monkey See, Monkey Shit. We got a Legal Immigrants the musical. That was my idea. I mean, a friend of mine wrote it, but that was my story. We got married. I know. It's insane. I guess all that anger I had towards her was just love. In a way. Yeah, but she asked me about 12 times. You know, she actually married me. She asked me to marry her. I guess out in Russia, that's how they do it. They ask the man or something. But the first 12 times, I said no to her face, literally. And she actually got her psychopathic criminal cousin, Ermouf, from Moscow to fly out to New York, you know, through JFK Airport. And he just kind of beat and tortured me for about 2 weeks. You know, I mean, you know, until I said yes. I mean, you know, when you got a mechanical vice attached to your ball sack, you know, how can you say no? So that's how that happened. But like, this is all, we got our teen troupe going on, and these are all pictures of the kids. Some of the kids are delinquents, and they kind of just get involved in the teen troupe, and, you know, we kind of break it out of their mold, you know. The crackheaded parents drop them off, and we just go to work, so. I'm happy, you know. I'm very happy how the building came about. Yeah, this is the second floor. You know, downstairs would be the first, upstairs would be the third, but right here you're on the second.
There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing. Everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you open and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they hung a star. Let's go on with the show. The costumes, the scenery, the makeup, the props, the audience that lifts you when you're down. The headaches, the heartaches, the backaches, the flops, the sheriff who escorts you out of town. The opening when your heart beats like a drum. The closing when the customers don't come.